A demultiplexer circuit receives input from a single line and directs it to one of the 2 power n possible output lines. And we will have n select lines which will decide which of the 2 power n output lines we have to choose to direct the input. Okay, say for example, here A and B will act as the select line and E is the information that we wanted to pass on to any one of the lines D0 to D3. Okay, say for example, E is 1 and E0 is 0. Okay, that means that I wanted to pass the information 1 to any one of these lines D0 to D3 based on the input to A and B. Say for example, A is 1 and B is 0. In that case, which will be enabled? We will have this NAND gate will be having 1 for the inputs for A and B, and enable comes to be 0, and NAND gate will give the output 1, right? So D2 is 1, and the information E that we have here is passed on to D2 based on the inputs to the lines A and B. So we have passed. You might ask, okay, for this input, all other gates D0, D1, everything is giving the output 1. Okay, but that is not of our interest. Okay, our interest is D2 should get 1. Okay, we don't mind if D0, D1, D3 is also getting 1 as output. Okay, our aim is that we should get 1 to D2. Let's consider the reverse case. Suppose if I wanted to pass on the information 0 to the output line, which is D2. In that case, our E dash will be 1. Okay, so in this case, I wanted to pass on 0 to D2 since the select line is 1, 0. In that case, all other gates except D2 will output 1, and only here we will get all the inputs are 1 to the NAND gate, so we will get the output 0. Okay, and we have passed on the information E to the line D2. Okay, so this is how the demultiplexer will work. Okay, so the enable input will act as the information that we wanted to pass, and the input lines in the decoder will act as the select lines. There is one more advantage in using the decoders with enable input. Suppose if we wanted to build a decoder with higher configuration and that configuration is not available in the market, then we can use lower configuration decoder to build a bigger one. Okay, say for example, we have used 3 to 8 decoders to build 4 to 16 decoder. We have 3 inputs, okay, and 1 enable input. Okay, and when this enable is 0, we are going to get the output of D0 to D7 based on the values of X, Y, and Z. And when W is equal to 1, then D8 to D15 will get the output. Any one of the lines will be 1 based on the select lines X, Y, and Z. Thus, we can extend the configuration of 3 to 8 decoder to 4 to 4. We have enable input. Okay, so all these 4 inputs now will act as the input to the decoder, and we get the output from D0 to D15. So in this case, we have considered the implementation of the decoder using AND gate. Okay, so we have when W is equal to 0, okay, all the AND gates of this decoders will be 0, and here we will have, based on this, one of the AND gate will be 1. Okay, and when W is equal to 1, then all the decoders corresponding to all the AND gates corresponding to this decoder will be 0, and one of the AND gate will be 1 based on the values of X, Y, and Z. We can implement the combinational logics using the decoders. For example, this is the equations of the full adder for sum and carry. Since we can generate all the minterms using the decoder, it's that we need to have an OR gate equal to the number of outputs that we have. So we have two outputs here for a full adder, one for sum and the other for carry. So we have two OR gates. We can supply the input 2, 3, 2, 8 decoder, because we have 3 inputs, so there will be 8 possible minterms. All of them will be generated by the decoder, and we need to connect the lines corresponding to 1, 2, 4, 7. Okay, 1, 2, 4, 7 to 1 OR gate to produce the sum. The carry will be generated by connecting 3, 5, 6, 7. Okay, we have 3. 5, 6 and 7 connected to the other OR gate. Thereby we can implement any combinational logic using the decoders.